Shinjuku District, Bathhouse, Tokyo, Japan. The settlement is in Tokyo and is planning to meet with an unknown party to sell off the last of the information this day's gathered from Sir Casey and Morgan Wood. Shetland's partners must be identified and Shetland must be stopped. Now, that is the assumption that we are proceeding under. And greetings, folks. Welcome back to Tom Clancy's Splinter Cell as a field interrogator. Wait, Tom Clancy's Splinter Cell Chaos Theory as a field interrogator, my bad. However, the story thus far is that we figured out Shetland was the main bad guy and he had obtained the mask rules from two computational theorists known as Casey and Morgan Wood. However, right now we are acting under the assumption that he actually wants to sell those, sell the mask kernels to the highest bidder or something along those lines. And we have reason to believe why he might want to do that, because he's actually meeting with some people called the Red Mission. So we are going into the bathhouse to figure out who his business partners are and stop both parties. Once and for all. So, with that being said, here you go.
What do you mean the attack came from Japan? They're our allies!
Mr. President, these attacks represent the most sophisticated application of information warfare ever imagined. The missile launch came through Japan, yes, but it seems likely it was triggered by elements of a private security operation, Displace International.
Displace? That's Doug Shetland's outfit. We have contracts with them.
Who's Shetland?
Former Marine Recon, among the very best. He was one of my top candidates for third echelon a few years ago. No love lost for the military or the United States. Rumor is that we hung him out to dry for political reasons over an incident that wasn't his fault. We can only speculate as to what his agenda is.
Well, how do we defuse the situation until we know?
Maybe the Chinese can help.
Gotcha.
Echelon tracked down Doug Shetland in Tokyo 6 hours ago. He's mobile and he's wireless. And from what we've managed to decrypt, it looks like he's about to wrap up his business with whoever his Japanese contacts are. From what we've managed to pick out of the air, it looks like he and his men are about to converge on a bathhouse in the middle of the city. We need to find out who Shetland is meeting with, and do everything we can to prevent him from closing his deal.
Clearly, the attack that crippled the Walsh and force-launched the missile from the battery went through Seoul, but it originated in Japan. Shetland has something to do with it, and my line into the Displace servers shows that he's definitely profiteering on this war. In order to shut down his operation and prevent any further escalation, we need to ID his business partners and make sure they don't leave there with any more of Zerkezi's weaponized algorithms.
Fisher, the bathhouse where this meeting is going down is a semi-public place. There will be civilians in there, and probably a boatload of goons. Shetland's men seem to be popping up all around Tokyo in the last hour or so, and converging simultaneously on the location. Frances Cohen has been in Asia for the last few months, and she's found some ties between the bathhouse ownership and a Japanese criminal organization known as the Red Nishin. It's possible that they are Shetland's partners.
So, it's nice how Grimfangs says that her line into the Displace servers give her a clue about what's going on, because guess who put those lines there? Sam did. Back when he went into space to figure out the real identity of Marlon Nerich and what actually happened and how Displace is involved and all this. Turns out they're totally involved all the way from the top to the bottom. At any rate, the loadout doesn't really matter, so let's just go.
Fisher, I just got a request from Frances Cohen.
What does she need?
She's been trying to get a man inside the bathhouse for a long time to keep tabs on the Red Nishin. She wants to know if you can tap the phone lines in and around the building.
Frances? Of course I can.
Now, it isn't entirely true what I just said about the loadout being completely useless, because, well, the loadout does have its uses. Especially when they're talking about
Tell me why we're out here again. Boss needs us to check all the DSL frequencies, make sure that we won't get any network interference on the shaft.
I don't don't even know what that means. Be quick about it.
The stench is unbearable.
No kidding. I think there must be a broken sewer main back here. Worst part is you can smell it inside, too, in the basement.
What?
Yeah, some kind of foundation problem. All of Tokyo is sinking, you know.
Tokyo isn't sinking, idiot. The airport is sinking.
Whatever. Close enough.
Well done. So, I don't know if this guy is a civilian or a one of the henchmen, but he is what he is, and yeah, we need to essentially tap that phone that goes, that's the police phone that we need to tap right out here among the rest of the baddies, and that guy's reached out again. I hope that does not fare badly for us. See, it's not entirely true that the smoke, that the loadout does not matter, because, well, Redding's recommendation actually gives you an additional smoke that you can use to, well, smoke out bad guys. And this guy, he does not seem to have a gun, so I'm just going to go ahead and assume that he's a civilian. And we will proceed ahead under that assumption.
Good work, Fisher. That's the first phone line. See if you can tap into the rest.
I'm guessing somebody saw me. One of those guys there, probably. Alright. Found him back up. Can I not? Yeah, I can. Thank you. And we'll be following this all the way around. Or until at least a part of it, to where we can actually interrogate some folks. Because that is something that I do plan on doing, interrogating folks, I mean. Maybe I came the wrong way if I wanted to interrogate folks, I mean. Oh, I'll just stick to the path that I can see, instead of trying to climb all over the place. I think we can take this street light out. That should help us with our first interview, folks. Alright then. First order of business. Take
that
you out.
Time, I'm sure I saw something. Yep.
Oh, you saw nothing.
No such thing as being too careful.
Really? Look at you guys. Why don't you come here? Let me grab you from behind.
Nothing here.
Nothing there.
Never
indeed.
Hurts to check.
But I was hoping you would have some information for me. Unfortunately, that is not the case. As we have now found out the hard way.
I think I saw something!
No, you did not. Think that guy's a gun? Okay, you're a part of them. Alright, I'm gonna grab you too. I thought you were just a technician. Turns out you're not. You're more than that, aren't you?
Oh damn.
No. Don't be afraid. Being afraid will not get you anywhere, and I can interrogate you. I thought you were civilian, but you turned out to be one of the crooked bad guys.
What are you doing back here?
Oh my god! We're supposed to check the DSL connections! Make sure there's no interference!
Why? Is Shetland setting up a network?
Yeah! Something he calls a shadow net! Portable wireless network! Operates between standard Wi-Fi frequencies. Almost impossible to tap.
Thanks for your help.
No problem. Please! I'm just a contractor!
A private military contractor. With that being done, let us go and infiltrate the actual bathhouse. I was hoping that the other guys would know something as well, but that's a whole bunch of shit right there.
Stinks.
Just a reminder, Sam. You'll have some civilians in the bathhouse. Do not, I repeat, do not kill any of them.
I'll be careful.
Be more than careful. Be Gandhi.
Yes, sir.
Yes, I'm trying not to see if...
Central, this is 7. Finish the basement. All clear. Yeah, okay. 7 out.
Right then, what do you know?
Let's do this the easy way. Give me a small piece of useful intelligence, and in return, I won't kill you.
That sounds more than fair. What can I tell you?
How many men you have here?
Oh, actually, I have no idea. Shetland organized us like a flash mob. We were scattered all around Tokyo. The call came, we all showed up with our own part of the plan.
Interesting.
I was just supposed to come and secure this basement. I didn't even know there would be others here. Never mind how many.
So if you guys are familiar with the Duel Splinter Cell 1, there's this strategy that Nicolaudze had come up with to use in conjunction with the Maskers that was called the Glass Dagger. You would reference this level as well when you hack into Shetland's laptop. And the thing is, the Glass Dagger, it's this attack strategy wherein once a force comes under attack, it can shatter like a glass dagger into many tiny fragments, and then they can all head their own way and attack, you know, different parts of different parts of the enemy infrastructure without needing a common command center, or without having to rely on a larger group to accomplish that. And that was only enabled through the use of the Masse Kernel, since it more or less separated or broke down a huge task into many different components. So that's what the Glass Dagger was. Now, in this level, you reference it being an influence of Nicolaudze's Glass Dagger once you figure out, once you obtain the plans of how Shetland intends to use Nicolaudze's Masse Kernels. So what he does instead is he more or less programs the Masse Kernels in such a way that that multiple tiny units or multiple tiny shards of a glass dagger come back and rejoin into a single dagger. In other words, this guy here, he doesn't know what he's doing here at all. He's just, hanging around chilling in Tokyo when he gets a message about some mission parameters. And these parameters have been given to him by, none other than the program program derived from the Masse Kernels. So,
low-level tasking and high-level governance means none of us even needs to know the details of an operation.
See? So basically, I mean, he just knows what he needs to do. And the Masse Kernels, they more or less coordinate the entire attack through the use of multiple tiny, units, one-line units. It just gives everybody their instructions. And they come together at a certain point in time, at a certain place, without ever knowing what the other guy is doing or what's actually going on. All they need to know is what their own task is. And they all work together to accomplish it. So that way, I mean, it's like the information is very secure. Nobody actually knows what's going on.
Each of us has his low-level tasking, like secure this basement. There's a shared set of high-level rules, like never fire on another displaced employee. Each of us has his low-level tasking.
Sorry if that explanation was a little difficult or a little boring, but I just thought I might as well explain it. Because the thing about the first Splinter Cell is that it had some really amazing lore, but there's something here. Ah, this light. So the thing about the first Splinter Cell is that it had some really amazing lore, but it never advertised it. You had to actually read through the data sets that you'd obtained in each mission if you wanted to figure out what the lore was. So yeah, I mean, that's why. Now, to grab this guy, we need to go through some sort of tricky right here. I accidentally shot the fan, so shouldn't do.
Those guys don't look Japanese to me.
Yeah, expensive suits cut wide in the shoulders. They're packing for sure.
Exactly.
What's
I'm
with the light?
I'm making displays. Trying to keep a low profile.
Makes sense. Doug knows how to stay discreet when it's necessary.
I can hear you moving around. Well, that's the last thing we'll do. Let's just drag you all the way back into the corner in case somebody comes here. Even though there should not be anybody coming here. Still, nonetheless. Let's do that. Anyway. It's a pity you don't know anything of value. This next section can get a little tricky. I'll try to interrogate
Fisher,
you, but
in order to figure out who Shetland is meeting with, you'll need to head up into the private offices. Check upstairs, to the north of your position, and past reception.
On my way.
That guy's gonna come over here. Maybe I'll grab you first. Oh wait, you're the civilian. You're not a target. I tend to forget that from time to time. That there are civilians in this level. So it's totally up to RNG at the beginning of the level. If there are any of these guys might be. Sometimes these guys are up here, sometimes like sometimes those guys are the civilians fixing something over there, sometimes he's fixing something over there. And you don't really know which base he's gonna be in. This base guard's using torch. Yes. Using torches. But unfortunately, well, maybe I might find something useful from him yet.
Cooperate, and I won't cripple you.
Well, damn.
What?
Tell me anything you can about the area you're guarding.
The lobby and upper offices are to the north. The baths themselves are to the south.
Wow. You're pretty spineless.
A lot of people say I'm too nice. Maybe that's why they never let me guard an area alone. I'm not a very good mercenary.
I suppose you're not. I turn it up, leaving the guards by the soldier. Oh, not. Oh, not.
What is that?
That guy.
There's also some sake in the kitchen. Good stuff.
You took some of it, didn't you? Yes, both of these doors are now open. Although nobody really knows what they saw, or if they saw anything at all. That guy's coming over here to investigate, but he's a civilian, so I'll just leave him be. That guy's here again. I would rather grab that guy without the civilian noticing.
Not a trace.
Not a trace indeed. Not a trace indeed. Just the way I prefer it, Mr. Good, good, good. Other guys might be here soon. And he's going away. So I wanted to grab him before we went to the event proper. I guess we can't exactly do everything all the time. Would you happen to know something? Of course you wouldn't. Why would you? That would be a direct violation of your commands, wouldn't it? There's another guy over there. Two people, actually.
Is the upstairs secure?
Yeah. Might be some Red Mission guys up in the private rooms, but I didn't disturb them. How about the front?
It's tight. A truck is blocking the alley, and I sent the guys unloading it for a coffee break.
Which guys?
Just some guys. Worker guys.
What? You just said, hey, why don't you guys take a break, and they did?
Well, I gave them 100,000 yen.
Oh, okay. Well, don't forget to expense that.
Yeah, no kidding.
Hey, is this guy gonna come here? No, he's not. Good, good, good. If he did, it would be pretty bad. We can beat around here.
We're on the 16th fairway with about 200 yards.
But what I would rather do is access this computer. Disables the camera system, and that's it. That's all I want to do. Really, disable the camera system. I'm gonna come in and see.
What is that?
Good question, why don't you come over and check? Well, I just gave you just to interview you, and I'm gonna use this route for my operations this time around.
Shh. You know what I'm after.
Probably Shetland. Everyone else seems to be.
Where is he?
He's meeting someone in the private baths at the back. Not sure who. Not exactly sure when. But soon.
What's his escape plan if something were to go wrong?
I don't know, but I'd bet on helicopter extraction from the roof.
I see.
Kill me if you want.
Well, I don't really want to kill you. That would be sort of counterproductive. It's difficult timing that guy. I like this guy. We need to be around. I think the boost is good. It's difficult to see through glasses and the enemies as well. Well, this, that guy seems to have gone back upstairs, so I'll just wait for him down here. Who he is? And since the camera has been taken care of, whoops. We can essentially just walk upstairs without any issues whatsoever. Sad that this guy doesn't know what he can do. I was hoping he would. Now, I wonder if there's something upstairs. Security cameras. I sort of. made sure that there was the camera feed. I think that is the guy that is upstairs. But in case it isn't, I'm just gonna go ahead and see. That camera is still rolling about. But yeah, I can't see nothing. There's a civilian there that I do not want to see. My primary objective is that guy right there. I mean, sometimes interrogating civilians does have its uses as well, but yeah, there is a that I do not really want to involve them in anything. It's crazy how that guy did not see Sam's shadow sneaking up onto him. Now, if you actually use the Interrogator right here, you'll be able to see nothing because this door is locked. Yep, the door is shut, so you can actually see anything. We need to have this keypad, this though that we're not it. 19140. 19140, no, there's only one 19 number. That works out in our favor, I suppose. I'm just closing the door for privacy. We don't really need to close it.
There.
Got it. Shetland's meeting in the private baths in the back of the bathhouse in a little while.
Who's he meeting?
Red Nishin, from the looks of it. Cohen was right. The bathhouse owner is pretty high up in the Japanese mob.
I don't know. That doesn't sound like Shetland's style.
Well, unless you find something to the contrary, it looks like a solid lead to me.
I'll keep sniffing around.
So, from Yaku to Haru, reservation. Haru, I hope I did not upset you. Of course, you are the Red Nishin, and you are always welcome to use our facilities. I will see to it that our special guests do not disturb you. Now, this right here, is a pretty big spoiler. So, I mean, we don't know that the ISD is here yet. We know that once you get over into the next room, access go through this.
Fisher, those two aren't displaced. They're ISDF assault troops.
What is ISDF doing here?
Maybe the Red Nishin has sold Shetland out to the ISDF. Eavesdrop on that meeting. Figure out what's going on before ISDF blows this up.
How are we going to stop them?
I'll get on the horn with Admiral Otomo and make sure we're all on the same page.
A shot on that, do you? Red Nishin doesn't have that kind of technology. And Shetland, you don't think...
Should we tell Canada?
No. There is no way Shetland had time. Besides, we are in a hurry.
I wonder what they actually noticed. I mean, their voices were sort of overshadowed by Lambert squawking with the speakers. Okay, time to grab these guys. And squeeze them for information.
What are you guys doing here?
How did you get here?
I ask, you answer.
We are here to monitor the meeting with Shetland.
Who gave the orders?
I am following the orders of a man named Kaneda. But he's someone's pawn. He's not even a real military.
Kaneda, huh? Thanks. You're gonna take a nap now.
I am not afraid to die.
That was just sort of locking you out. People just want to kill you. Calm down, man. You're gonna give yourself a headache. This guy, of course, knows nothing either. I'll put you to sleep as well. Too bad I can put you guys on the beds themselves. Alright, what is this computer happening? The same thing, I suppose, that the computer has. And yeah, I suppose we could actually, like, not the notes, but I think the data might have something. No, that's just reservation, that's it. Nothing else. Oh. Yeah, this thing is leaned against it. Door, we can't exactly move it. I mean, Sam could move it, but we don't really have the option to do that. So let's head back downstairs then. Now that one of the cameras has been eliminated. I've seen some players actually use this very corridor to infiltrate the room at the top, which is seriously impressive, to be honest. No, let's just use this spot. I don't know where the civilian is right now, but he's right there. Maybe time to get a move on. I was not expecting that guy to be there. I've got no idea where this goes, but well, it's something. Oh, okay, you're gonna come in right now. Alright. No idea what she did there, but you did something, that's for certain. Bye-bye, I'll see you later. I'll just see you guys there. I'll wait for this guy. Otherwise, he's gonna see you because this is like a mirror right in front of him. Sometimes he stands here and he poses for a brief bit. Wow. Not what I wanted to do. Can you see yourself in the mirror? Why don't you come over here and grab a look. Oh, the walking animations are a little janky. Take a good, nice, close look at that knife at your throat. You can probably see it in the mirror, can't you? Probably better than I can.
What are you doing here all alone?
Jesus! Oh, please!
What's past the locker rooms?
The corridor. To the right is the public baths. To the left is the pool. But the pool is being repaired.
Thanks for the info, but I'm not here for a swim.
The baths are well defended. The pool... I don't know if anyone is in there.
That's better.
Please! I've been afraid of locker rooms since I was a boy!
Oh. I guess I better put you to sleep so that you don't get too afraid of anything. The good thing about this game is you can just leave bodies lying out of the light. Nobody's really gonna be the wiser. Dry bath. And that's the pool level. Which way do you want to take this mission? Let's try going this route to the dry bath. But then again, in doing so, we are essentially skipping a large portion of the game. So let's just go back this way. I want to interrogate as many people as possible. I guess it's more of a choice as to where you go. Comes down to personal preference, I suppose. After a point in time. Should I take out the generator then?
I know. 6 weeks out of warranty. Bam.
That'll keep the lights off for longer. Let me grab what I want to.
All clear.
Really now? I thought it was not all clear. You wouldn't have a clean room, would you? About enough. I'll just smoke the other fighter. I'll go over there and grab your friend. Come on then. Don't be shy. Tell me what you know. And we won't have to get rough with you. There's supposed to be a guy in there walking on his walking the floor, but.
Way to go, Sam. Cohen says there's one more phone line she'd like you to tap.
That's the first phone line they've encountered in a while, but this part of the game it's sort of easy to forget that we have to tap phone lines in this level. Now I'm gonna go ahead and over to the inside and check out what's there. These are supposed to be tryouts, but I don't know how much of the level we're skipping in the coming. Interesting facility. Only one guy here. I don't think I've been through this route. I mean, even if I have, it's been like ages ago. Strange how the other guy did not go this way. I did not see that part at all. There's two sort of water paths in this world. I guess that's how the normal difficulty is quite forgiven. There's not tripping alarm anytime you miss objectives like these. Something getting spotted by civilian in there. Massage. I guess the simplest solution is to just wait out here until the civilian comes out. It goes for a smoke in that room over there. I mean, this guy's just moving about all over the place and just smoking in different massage chambers. That's all he's doing really. He's gonna sit there for a while and then he's gonna go ahead and smoke in one of these chambers again. Strangely enough, these civilians tend to notice us much faster than the actual bad guys. Oof, almost got noticed there. And this is another way into the bathhouse then.
No one here. No signs of disturbance.
Interesting. I guess that's because this guy wanted to enter a dialogue. And we're not skipping a lot. Is there any seat in here yet? Or... I mean, there's another cylinder over there. This room is supposed to be full of steam, but I guess that only happens when we enter through that side then. I'm gonna save it. Before I try something pretty stupid. Where's the wolf? Oh, there's the wolf. Okay. We're gonna go ahead and activate that wolf then. Ah, I guess we don't need to do that. this civilian did it for us. Are you guys not gonna have your conversation about how you guys used to work for this place for a long time? I guess you'll be having it now? No? As you wish. So honestly, I don't know where to keep this guy. Because while I'm doing this, that guy's gonna be walking away with this. And I need to figure out where to keep this guy. In a place where he won't get detected by other people. Maybe here? I don't know. I honestly don't know where to keep this guy. There's very little problem in this section. No, maybe we can just go. Is somebody here? I do not think so. Let's just keep you right here. Should be better for both of us, I think. Maybe a little further down the hallway.
Gotcha.
Damn, I knew I'd get caught in here.
Crap!
Tough break, pal.
Nothing!
Tell me something I don't know.
Well, our thermal vision kit didn't get distributed yet, so we can't see for crap. But some of the guys that came in with Shetland, I think they're fully equipped.
Shetland's personal bodyguards have thermal?
I think so. Not that it does much good in steam. Steam isn't fog, like in an abattoir or something. Steam is warm, just like human bodies.
Good point. Thanks for the explanation.
Anytime. I can't hear too good either. Not because of the steam, though.
Yeah, because... God.
Psst, over here.
You sort of got to... I think you got you lost your hearing in a bomb bust. Sometime during the... Something happened, I forgot what exactly happened, but something happened, I think, which made that guy lose his hearing. Now... I was thinking all this while that Shetland's bodyguards have night vision, but apparently they have steam, which is something totally strange. Like, I was not expecting that. Let me just move a bit. Now, should I actually risk it? Maybe. Right, so this guy actually got spooked too, where he decided that he doesn't want any piece of this, and he decided to go over all the way in there. But we can wait here, or we can try to force the action, which will cause him to come back here, come back this way again. But I'd rather wait here. It's a little safer this way. At least I feel like this. There it goes.
I saw something there.
You did? These guys act like...
Nothing here. I'm sure there's nothing here.
It's like the AI is set to advance or something. Because this must certainly act like that. With realistic difficulty. Because he was not supposed to be able to see me there. Especially through the cover. That is, uncalled for. Should have saved there. Blindness.
I saw something there.
No, you did not. So bye. Where is this guy? Oh, over there. Psych. I got you. Okay, how are you? I wonder. Not that you know that to be saved. Damn, that seal is gold. But then again, I suppose it is a condition of seal to be gold. You can see nothing. You can still see nothing. I suppose that's what the other guy was talking about. Then he was talking about the unreliability of thermal against steam. The guy seems like he's nearby, so might as well wait for him to come here before I try and grab him. Or maybe he went away. I cannot effectively be girl this morning. Yeah, I can't see where he is. He should be coming here soon, though. But if he does, I won't be able to grab him. Sounds like he's coming here. Yeah, there he is. Good thing he doesn't have his night vision on yet. Come over here, why don't you? Take a nap. He's been moving pretty hard. It's a pity you didn't know anything, though. You didn't jump into my ass. Couldn't find a single piece of information from most of you guys.
Done.
That's the last phone line, Fisher. Cohen sends her thanks.
Tell her it was my pleasure.
Well, it certainly was. So grabbing the guy in this next section isn't really difficult. Not that pretty sure that will not help at all, but hopefully it will help if I steam out here. And he goes to check it out. You have to bait around a lot for these guys. I wonder if knocking these guys out ahead of time actually makes the upcoming encounter easier for us.
Zachary!
Yes, sir.
I just double checked the blueprints. Turns out there's a vent that comes out in the meeting room. ISDF makes me nervous. Make sure the vent is clear of any surveillance gear.
Yes, sir.
Be quick about it. The meeting will start soon.
I'm on it.
Absolutely. Well, there is no surveillance gear in there. Right now, there's gonna be some surveillance gear in there when Fisher comes to check, but
was that candle not burning earlier?
Why do these guys put those silly accents? I guess I can knock you out. Yeah. That's good, 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 good. There's a guy right there. And I have not been seen by him. Okay, let's try this again.
What's wrong with the lights?
Good question, what is wrong with the lights? Come over here, check it out.
Nothing here but ghosts and shadows.
I wouldn't say that, but...
See? There it is again.
Oh, damn. I did not expect you to be there.
Tell the whole world we're coming, why don't you?
At least you don't have a torchlight in your hands, though.
Nothing here. Looks like I'm being overcautious.
Overcautious is better than dead, son. I hope you've come back to memory. No, then what can I tell you?
You find anything?
What?
Did you find anything?
What? You mean in the vents? No.
So there's no reason to expect anyone is spying on Shuttlin's meeting?
No, I don't think so.
Well, I guess I'll have to do it then. Good night.
Good night. And the stupid insurance application is sitting on my desk!
Do it for him, don't kill me. The insurance application is sitting on his desk, apparently. Now then, this guy.
This guy think he's dealing with amateurs?
Well, yes. Frankly. Because you guys certainly behave like a bunch of amateurs, that's for sure.
Tell me about your fallback defenses.
What? Who the?
Calm down. Just tell me what I want to know.
Okay. The plan is, if something goes wrong, to choke off the back hallway.
Why?
Shetland has a helicopter circling. It can pick him up on 3 minutes' notice. If we're compromised, we just need to defend the perimeter until he's clear.
Where will the chopper touch down?
On the roof, through the maintenance corridor, past the private showers.
Not gonna be. Okay. Putting the light off was actually a good decision, in hindsight. But this, I think, is another one of the ways that we can come here. I think we do come across this way through the chance pathway when we actually build this level for real. Now, are there any other folks here that I can essentially interrogate ahead of time, maybe? Does not seem to be anybody there. Let's just blow up this candle just to be safe. Okay, can I not open these doors? Oh, that's sad. No access for us, huh? We'll not yet at least. I think there isn't anybody out there anymore. So yeah, I think we can safely proceed through the section here. Doing a ball for the firefight starts there. I may have just stuck myself with the vehicle.
Lambert, ISDF is in the building. Are they making their move?
It's all clear.
I haven't been able to contact Otomo. I don't know what's going on.
Wait a minute.
Yes, this will do just fine.
Care of everything, we're secure.
Jesus, Lambert. SDF isn't here to take Shetland down. They're meeting with him. They're his partners.
My God. Stay there. We need to hear the details before we go to the Joint Chiefs with this.
Did not bring them? We're not going to follow you across Tokyo.
Relax, Kaneda. I'll just download them and burn you a disc.
Huh? You take me for a fool? You are not stupid enough to download them over a public network. What are you up to?
I said relax. You're right. I'm not that stupid. My men just finished setting up a shadow net. Completely secure wireless, discreet from the web. Now sit. You'll have your algorithms in about 4 minutes. Call it!
Lambert.
Let it go, Fisher. We know the truth. We'll pick up the pieces after the dust settles.
Save it, Kaneda. I've seen it before. You're defending your honor to cover up your lies. Should I check the account, or should we start shooting and see who walks out of here?
Kaneda! That's the wall! No! No, no! Please! We can work this out!
We're switching the fallback.
The chopper's on its way.
Good. Secure this area. No one comes through.
Yes, sir.
Fisher?
Kill Shetland. I know.
The firefighters inside here. On me.
Cover me! Reto covering fire!
Sir, complete an installation of the requested algorithms and solve the required software in order to maintain operation security. All that is required is entry of the tasks and subtasks and allocation of the number of assets and execution time and location. The algorithm will then generate the mission plan and contact your men remotely when needed. So nobody actually knows what's going on. They just come together to accomplish a common goal, and that's pretty much what this is. Well then, I died to the landmine. And everything is going so well. Well, you're gonna try something new, huh? I suppose that plan did not succeed.
Take him down! Any way you can! He's reloading! Let's take him while he's snapping! Use terminal force!
That way you got him!
I can't see him!
Good, good, good. Not being able to see them is the ideal condition. Alright. There's a camera there, but we've already hacked it. Is that up? I feel like that might provide me with an approach where I can actually move through the section without getting alerted, without alerting the guards. Correct. That can help. Alright. Nothing. Before we head over into the next section, we need to save.
This is pointless, Sam. You won't know what to do if you catch me. Why bother chasing?
My God, Fisher! Shetland has rigged the place to blow! There are bombs hidden in the furnace room. You'll have to find them all, and fast!
Right,
no more to them than any other weapon.
It's So I'm getting this in a cup again, where the enemy is just a little bit under. Without politician.
Give me a hand!
Oh, what? That's how you want to play it. Might as well go ahead and disappoint my nigga.
Made yourself the instrument of a policy you don't believe in, Sam. Walk away.
I'll try something. I'll of course go here and set up another one of these wall mines for the next guy. Here. The only reason that I'm selecting the six chopper is because it's very efficient. I wonder if this guy's gonna blow up.
Blood is thicker than water, and you and I have bled a lot together. You're trading your honor for their agenda.
That did not work. How did you get past that area?
What was that?
Right then. That was sort of a beast. I don't know why I keep getting the same bug over and over again.
It doesn't have to end like this, Sam.
No, but it does have to end.
On that we agree. We've been fighting their dirty little wars our entire lives, and where do we end up? Staring at each other down the barrels of our guns. Nothing has changed, Fisher. And it won't change by degrees. We have to tear it down and start over. It's the only way.
Your own little chaos theory. Throw the world into war and hope that what comes out the other side is better.
It will be better. Because this war will change things, Sam. Every other war has been about keeping things the same, but the status quo doesn't work anymore. America's sick, Sam. She's dying. The politicians, the bureaucrats, the whispered backroom deals, it's all life support for a sick old lady who was dead a long time ago.
The only backroom deals that I've seen lately were made by you. You're a murderer and a war criminal.
Those are the only names the state has for the revolutionary, Sam. You only become a hero after the war is over. You know the truth. The world is built from the bottom up, not the other way around. Honor, courage, fidelity. We don't inherit these things from the world, Sam. We build the world from them. I know you. You believe in these things more than any government. And I know that because of it, you wouldn't shoot an old friend.
You're right, Doug. I wouldn't shoot an old friend.
Alright then, that was Mission Bathhouse, and disappointingly enough, I still got the same bug all over again. Well, the enemies were just aware of my presence in the area without ever, you know, me giving them I never gave them a reason to be aware of me in the first place, but they still were. So that is quite strange, in my opinion, that I'm sort of facing this bug these days. Next playthrough, I'll probably try and maybe run this game compatibility mode, but I don't know what's going on. So with that being done, Shetland has been eliminated. Of course, it will be getting the hit to our score, because we did get into some quite a bit of open combat, and a body was discovered. So, yeah, we came here to figure out who Shetland is dealing with and eliminate him. We have been successful in both counts. However, the curveball here is the fact that Rednition, which translates to Red Herring in English, is essentially the ISD of itself, and Otomo is somehow involved in all of it. Or maybe he's not. We need to figure that out in the next mission, which would be Kokubu Sosho, or the Japanese Defense Ministry. Now, as far as this mission is concerned, we came in here and we oversaw the deal with the ISD of which went sideways, and what's his name? Shetland? Yeah, Shetland. We eliminated Shetland. So we have taken out the source of the Masse Kernel. Now all that remains is to take out, well, any of the recipients that might have actually got the Masse Kernel and are planning to use them. So thank you so much for tuning in. Thank you so much for watching. And thank you so much for sticking around until the end. The next time we come back, we will be heading to Kokubu Sosho to figure out to what extent the ISDF is involved in all this and who exactly inside the ISDF is pulling all the strings. Until then, take care. Let's just look at this 36 first. Yep, 87%, 27 enemies knocked out, twice identified as an intruder, and one body found. Oh well, it is what it is, I suppose. Can't really help it much more than that. Well then, until next time, fare thee well, fellow old things.